Hi there and welcome to our St. Paul's channel. Here we talk about email marketing news and ways to improve your marketing experience. Today we'll talk over the promotions tab in Gmail and the ways how you can avoid your emails landing there. So let's start going. Five years ago, Gmail began sorting incoming emails into tabs to simplify the inbox experience for its users. So how do they sort the many emails? Gmail introduced a smart and complex algorithm that looks at many factors, including content of the message, HTML code, email address the campaign was sent from, and so on. Just check out the chart to see what eventually happened. Less than 2% of all emails sent to Gmail users reach the primary tab, leaving a whopping 68% of emails in the promotions tab. As the situation is unlikely to change anytime soon, the question is, what can you do to get your emails to the primary tab? Worry not, to help you out of the evil promotional tab, St. Paul's team had carried out a test. We've sent emails to different Gmail users, experimenting with the content, number of links, and images. The results helped us to figure out some tips for optimizing your emails so that you can reach the primary tab. Let's start with the subject line. Going all caps lock or using chewed up words like buy now, hurry, hot sale, free, urgent is a highway to the promotions or spam tabs. Try to sound less spammy by keeping your subject line more conversational. Personalization is another aspect worth giving a thought. Mentioning a user's name or any other information relevant to them will create a digital handshake. This is what a friend or a colleague would do, right? Going beyond hello and adding some important data to the subject line will make your emails more personal. This way, Gmail is unlikely to classify your email as promotional, as it will see a difference in content. To be able to personalize your emails, collect a user's name at the sign-up stage and use merge text to customize your campaigns. Next, leave out the use of images and links. What looks like a promotion gets labeled as such and goes to the corresponding tab. So overloading your emails with images is a big no, because real people don't usually send lots of pictures in the emails. The same goes for links. Overfilling the email with links might also be perceived by Gmail as promotion. As we are trying to get out of that tab, remember to reduce the number of external links to no more than two, including the unsubscribe link. As for HTML use, the rule is quite simple. More plain text, less HTML. Gmail spam filters usually flag heavy HTML emails as spam. They check the email source code and find out if it has been usually typed or automated. Customize your emails so they resemble a personal conversation, having no sophisticated styling options and complicated coding inside. Keep your email text-based and make it look less like it was designed by an email marketing tool. Lastly, segmentation. Remember that your recipients are real people, so it's essential to send them relevant, engaging, and timely content. Moreover, if you notice a subscriber's engagement, it is worth a short asking them to manually move your emails from the promotions to the primary tab. Basically, all these rules mean one thing. Try to make your email look as if it is coming from a friend. Would they send you a load of images and more than two links? Would they use heavy coding and words like buy now? Well, you get the idea. Proceed to our article for more tips on how to get out of the promo jail. The link is in the description below. Found this video useful? Press like, subscribe to our channel, and press the bell icon to never miss any updates in the world of email marketing.